South Africa, stand up, y'all. Uh-huh. Back-to-back videos. Nasty C, now we with Proverb. I know this is another artist that we needed to get to for a long time. Writers Club's name of the song.
Yes.
And I know...
a lot of requests from you guys.
Huge requests, right?
I don't know anything about Proverb, though. Outside of those requests, I don't know anything about this gentleman. But I'm excited because I know that y'all give a fuck about bars. Y'all care about
That's true.
People who are nice with it, you know, who care about the craft.
And I like the album name, man. It's called Forthright. Forthright, as in a writer, right?
He's a writing motherfucker. See, yeah, like Writers Club, Forthright.
Yeah, you know I write saying? Books is another title. On
Damn.
So he obviously cares about his pen, man,
yeah.
and writing in general.
And
so
you guys know we appreciate that.
Yeah, man. And I think that's a perfect segue to doing a little bit of research on Mr. Proverb.
Yeah. You know, we need something.
Yeah.
Because we've had we've done Stogie T. Stogie T was our introduction. So the bar was set high. For South Africa.
Man.
Or anybody, especially South Africans, if you don't know about Stogie T, y'all better go do your research on Stogie T. And I know a lot of y'all do, but for those South Africans that aren't, you know, up on him, man, he's a legend in your area. So.
Just type in Lost in Vegas Stogie T.
Stogie T. We did the Sway in the Morning freestyle. Yep. Then we just did we're not sure when we're going to release it, but fuck it, we'll let the cat out the bag. We just did a video on Nasty C. It was a freestyle that he did on Sway in the Morning.
Yep.
So we trying to dig a little bit more into South Africa because you guys show us so much love when we do your artists, man. And we know that you guys care about the craft. So Proverb.
And rappers that write are needed.
So Proverb, it looks like from what I'm looking at here is he is clearly we know that he's a South African rapper. But this man is a radio, television personality. He's a presenter, technical producer, content producer, businessman. He's been out since what, 2005? The Book of Proverbs, I believe, was his debut album. His sissy's got a famous sister, apparently. Shout out to her. You know, Laredo, I believe. I don't know, you know, if I'm pronouncing that correctly. And speaking of presenter, he actually presented on the South African version of the hit music talent show Idols South Africa.
Okay.
So this dude, you know, he's a jack of many trades, it looks like, man.
You know what I love about that, man? Someone that is casting their net wide, right?
Mm-hmm.
Diversifying, you know, maybe he's not getting all of the accolades or maybe not getting all the revenue that he wants to get out of rap. Hey, I'm going to hit it in other ways.
Okay.
I'm going to be diversified and I'm going to, you know, take care of my family in other ways. I love that. I don't think you can
That's
lose
dope.
With that attitude.
I love that as well.
I don't
well.
Think you can.
And it looks like I don't know if he's the head of this label, but it looks like he's on an independent label. It says through independent record label known as Outrageous Records. So if he's doing his independent thing with it,
That's
while
cool.
still being,
yeah.
you know, a jack of many
That's
trades.
Good.
Okay.
Yeah.
Handing a lot of pots, man. Let's get into it, though. Proverb featuring, looks like Tebogo Moloto. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that correctly. Sorry if I'm not. Sorry. Mm-hmm. But let's get into it. Proverb Writers Club. I know he's about to come in, but it says, welcome to the Writers Club for all the writers with the Midas touch. And it said, MCs don't cipher as much. That's why we need the Readers and Writers Club.
Mm-hmm.
And then it said, so sign up. So obviously what he's saying is, man, it's a sort of
movement.
It seems like it's a movement.
Yeah.
It seems like he's trying to gear people into wanting to
write.
To focus on lyricism, essentially, right? And the cipher as much touch as well is interesting because you don't see ciphers as much anymore. You see freestyle still, but you don't really see a lot of it, or at least you don't see them. I shouldn't say that. I see a lot of ciphers. I don't know if they're as prominent in terms of popularity anymore, as visible on a mainstream level, but I see them.
Yeah.
So I think that's his goal, it seems like. And I don't know if this is an actual writer's club, so sign up. Or if he's just being used, saying, hey, man, get with the program, man. Focus on, mastering your craft. I'm not sure, but give us some feedback on that.
MCs don't cipher as much. That's why we need the Readers and Writers Club.
Sign up.
Welcome at the Writers Club for all the writers with the Midas touch.
Writers just like us.
MCs don't cipher as much. That's why we need the Readers and Writers Club.
Sign up.
All right, what I like
and I like what I write. I like to be right, but I don't really write to be liked. Difference, I get hype when I write like journalists, but I'm no journalist. So I don't write for the hype. And not to say the hype is not right, but writing won't get you hype. And having a hype doesn't mean you can write it. Hype is the right cover up, so that whatever you write just might get you undercover with hype. You can count from left to right how many writers are left, and you'll be left thinking it's not right. Just how many writers have been left stranded. It's quite a mess, like trying to write left-handed. But even though there's not much left,
he's still barring up like he's saying all that, bro. Damn.
Because I know when it's right and it's not right, because it's right and I like to write. And this, that
is. You a writing motherfucker, huh?
I'm making jokes, but that is difficult by itself. Slick. That's a skill set, man. And like
homonym, antonym, medley. Dude,
homonyms for your ass. Yeah, I will say that. I write what I like and I like what I write. I like to be right, but I don't really write to be liked. There's a difference, right? And he went into a right scheme that was crazy, right? But but one thing that I like about this style of writing and this structure is the creativity, and you have to be you just have to be on point, man, because it's so easy to fuck this up.
Yeah.
That's why I read that slow, because it's easy to fuck up, right? And right. Correct. Yeah. So
we gotta break up the rights in there.
But I really appreciate what he's doing here, because he's highlighting writing, you know. And I love the way he's playing on that write and write, like writing and to be right, to be correct. You know, I think that it's just dope, man. And I think it really makes your ears perk up, because you're like, wait a minute, what is he saying? And it makes you hone in on lyricism. So I got to give him credit for that.
It takes skill too, man. I mean, it's honing in on the craft of writing. You know what I mean? Because once upon a time, it was, you know, writing, you know, you had to be, bottom line is, any of your favorite rappers, even, and we're talking about 90s, 80s, whatever the case may be, man, it was there was more of a badge of honor to be able to write your lyrics at a certain level, you know what I mean? And it just feels, based off of what it seems like he's saying here, that that's not looked at or taken as seriously anymore. It's more about, you know, as we all see, man, the marketing and making viral hits and whatnot and all this other stuff, but it seems like the core of what rap was about has taken a back seat. So he's just trying to inspire people to be great writers. But with that line that you said, Ryan, I write what I like and I like what I write, I like to be right, but I don't really write to be liked. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
There's a difference.
I think he looks at writing as pure and just. Mm-hmm. He thinks that that's the right way to, that's the right.
to write. That's right, the right? correct way right. to write.
Right, you know, but he's not doing it just to be, he's not doing it for the likes. I'm not trying to make, you know, lyricism that sort of mass appealing. I'm not trying to, great if it happens, but I'm not trying to write what I think is this
for the hype.
So the formulaic structure, the hype.
And that's what he said, right? Yep. For the hype, right? He said that he's not writing for the hype, because I'm no journalist, right? He's all, but not to say that hype is not right and I don't want to get hype, but just because you get hype doesn't mean that you can write, right?
This just sounds crazy. I know this just sounds crazy as hell, especially for people who don't listen to hip-hop.
Yeah. But bottom line is, I know that was a lot, but bottom line is, I was trying to make that as quickly as and concise as possible. But the bottom line is, he's saying he's not writing for any ulterior motive.
Yeah.
I'm writing because I just think that it's needed. And we think that it's needed in hip-hop, but I think in everything, man. I mean, I just think you should want to pay attention to your craft, you know?
Be good at it. Be good at what you do.
But the way he ended that line, he said, just because you can write for the hype doesn't mean that you can write. It doesn't mean that you're a good writer. You're a good lyricist. You might be a good hype man. There's a lot of hype music and trap music and shit that you can shake your ass to right now that is hot. Like, by definition, it's hot popular, but it doesn't mean that you are lyrical and you can... you have a good pen and you can write well. So I like that. I like when you brought that point home.
There you go. You know, I mean, those qualifiers that we looked at when we were sort of evaluating someone's talent in rap, a lot of it had to do with lyricism.
Mm-hmm.
Now he's saying it's not about that. It's about the hype, the marketing, and all this other shit that's surrounding it. and the skill has been sort of missing. So mm-hmm. I like what he's about, man. And this has actually been a fun listen, man, seeing him just sort of mm-hmm. play with words and just, shit. Yeah. So let's get back to it.
You can count from left to right, how many writers are left, and you'll be left thinking it's not right.
It's not
just
right.
How many writers have been left stranded? It's quite a mess, like trying to write left-handed. But even though there's not much left that feels right, look, I'm still here, I have not left, I still write. I'm the author with so many books left to write, slash performer, still getting book left and right. Welcome to Writers Club for all.
We may have stopped it a little bit more. We may have been a little premature with the first stop. We should have let him just rock out that whole verse.
Yeah, we should.
He got crazy though after that. After we stopped it, I mean, it's been good overall. But I love because then he started going sort of the opposite, but yet correlating word, maybe the antonym or whatever the case mm-hmm. may be. When he said, "You can count from left to right, how many writers are left?"
Yep.
You'd be left thinking it's not right.
Yeah, that was hard.
Just how many writers have been left stranded? Yeah. It's quite a mess, like trying to write
left-handed. Yeah, that was hard.
But even though there's not much left that feels right, look, I'm still here. I have not left. I still write.
I still write.
There's still some, you know, there's still some dudes from the cloth that still
care about writing.
Trying to keep that torch lit. You know, that was slick.
That was hard. I love the way he put that whole verse together. That was hard. And the way he ended that verse.
Ended.
Was hard, man. Was hard.
I'm the author with so many books left to write, slash performer, still getting booked left to right.
Yeah.
Let's go over the bar.
He's like,
bro.
Sign up. Come on.
Yo, he finessed that shit.
Yeah, he did.
Performer, still getting booked left to right.
Yeah.
But even though there's not much left that feels right, look, I'm still here. I have not left. I still write. Yeah. I'm the author with so many books left to write, slash performer, still getting booked left and right.
Welcome
in the Writers Club for all the writers. With the Midas touch,
just like
MCs don't cipher as much. That's why we need the Readers and Writers Club. Welcome in the Writers Club for all the writers. With the Midas touch, MCs don't cipher as much. That's why we need the Readers and Writers Club.
I was gonna let that play out, George. I was very, very close to letting that play out, man. But I gotta touch on the hook, man. The chorus. Out of all that being said, I'm enjoying this listen. Let me preface it with saying that. Only thing that I'm not too happy with, man, if I had to give it any kind of feedback, man, just keeping it, you know, 100, is the chorus to me just sounds like an after school special, man. It just sounds like, hey, we like to write and this and that. It just sounds a little bit contrived. And I think that that's purposeful because I think I'm assuming he wants to bring a bigger audience to writing. So I can appreciate it. I just don't know if I necessarily like it, you know?
So when he says, so sign up, Ryan, to kind of talk about that, when he says, so sign up, I know it's important for me to get the clarification on what that means. Is it an actual writer's club that he's,
you know,
he's the president of and he wants people to sign up and this is more of a promotional thing? Because it is on his album, though.
Yep.
It's on Forthright. But also, does he have like a writer's club that he works? Because if that's the case, if it's this kind of a song to get people to sign up into this club, mm-hmm. it sounds like that. It sounds like an introduction that would be on like a motherfucking commercial for the Writers Club or whatever, mm-hmm. on a site or whatever the case may be. But if it's just, that's just the song, I agree 100%. It's a generic quality mm-hmm. to the chorus, you know what I mean?
But so, make no mistake about it, though. He's getting off, and I'm enjoying the song. I am enjoying it.
Fun listen, man. Yep. And the dude, he can write.
Yeah.
The dude is very, very slick. This is a fun listen. All right, let's get back to it.
Welcome in the Writers Club for all the writers with the Midas touch. MCs don't cipher as much. That's why we need the Readers and Writers Club. I write what I feel and I feel what I write. To get the right feeling, I put a feeling in what I write. And the feeling is what I write and the feeling is what I like. Call it light reading because reading it is the light. You're feeling me right. See, by speaking it through the mic and by reading it through the night, I'm leading you to the light. You're reading it right. You got the right to read. I'm reading your rights. So what I write to read, I'd like to see you see the light. And I see that you seem to like seeing an MC who writes. There's a danger in being seen as a real MC, because real MCs are an endangered species. That's the life that I'm trying to lead. I'm trying to lead writers back to life, because we're a dying breed. I'm trying to breed writers who write to lead and bring life to the writings that you're dying to read.
Welcome in the Writers Club for all the writers with a Midas touch. MCs don't cipher as much. That's why we need the Readers and Writers Club. Welcome in the Writers Club for all the writers with a Midas touch. MCs don't cipher as much. That's why we need the Readers and Writers Club.
Look, give me something to write. right, so I could write something you like. I know you like some of the rights. My type of writers are the type to recite at ciphers, but like ciphers, they phased out like typewriters. We gotta fight fire with fire and reignite the fire inside us. We need writers as fire lighters. I'm the type of fighter who's trying to inspire writers to see the light and put out fire like firefighters. I wanna burn the Fortune 5 list, cause unfortunately fortune drives us to write fortunes and five hits. The radio will force you to like it and cause you to buy it. I want you to read my thoughts like a psychic. I'm rather biased, have I found my heart's desires? I'm burning hot enough to start some forest fires. I'm more defiant and a little more defiant. There's only 4 to 5 writers, no more to find.
On a few bars before we kind of knock out our conclusions, man, because I mean I don't want to I want to make sure that this is not understated. The man got busy.
Yeah, he did.
He said, I'm the type of fighter who's trying to inspire writers to see the light and put out the fire like firefighters, to put out the fire, put out the great lyricism that we call fire, which is slang for just done very well. And but firefighters put out fires, right?
Hot.
That was hot. I want to burn the fortune. Then he continued, the firefighters, I want to burn the Fortune 5 list, because unfortunately, fortune drives us to write 4 tunes and 4 to 5 hits.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Or whatever the case may be, right? Mm-hmm. So 5 hits. So the way he played on, even the rhyming it within the rhyming, right? The 4 to 5, the 4 to 5, you know, this all requires skill and paying attention to detail and requires extra thought.
Dude, it does.
And when we're talking about writing, man, I mean, it's just, I think people don't realize that just in life, I've seen there, especially in music in general, man, I've seen that there's been sort of a diminished appreciation for skill.
Yeah.
I'm keeping it real with you, man. Yeah. And this is not just in hip hop. This is across the board. And I think the stakes are a lot higher than what people realize and what that means for humanity and us moving forward. And I don't want to get too deep with this shit. You know what I'm saying?
Go ahead, Carville.
Yeah, I don't want to do all that. But it's dire for him because I think it speaks to us just appreciating and more so acknowledging the importance of writing, which I think the root of that is the importance of, you know, keeping our minds sharp and keeping, you know, intelligence at the forefront, which is what we should always be about, man.
Yeah.
So I love the fight, you know, that he's put forth in this song to try to bring it back. Now, the song itself, with all that being said, the bars are there. I like the slickness. I like the technique. The bars are there. But the song is a little on the corny side to me. You know what I'm saying? What I mean by corny is it just comes off, the chorus comes off very sort of uninspired and sort of dialed in and generic to me. And the beat is just okay. The beat's not bad. The beat didn't do anything to sort of captivate me either. But I would say that because of the skill that was put into this, it really overshadowed those things for me and it made it a really, really cool listen. You know, but in order for me to put this on my playlist and just rock it out and enjoy the lyricism on top of that, I think the chorus really just, it kind of ruined it for me. But I think this dude is dope, and he succeeded in wanting me to see what else he has to offer, you know. But please let us know if this song is just more of a promotional song for an actual writer's club, or when he says sign up, just meaning like, hey, you know, apply yourself to wanting to write well. I'm not sure.
Yeah.
But dope. In terms of skill, dope. Fire.
I'm going to paraphrase a couple little lines here, man. I really like when he said the feeling that writing gives him is, he calls it light reading because reading is the light, you know. I thought that was cool. I really like the line that he talked about rappers being an endangered species, because he saw real MCs is because we're now in danger and we're an endangered species. He had a lot of depth within the wordplay and the homonym usage and all that kind of stuff. So I don't want to downplay that enough. I really, really like that. But the song for me, man, in general, man, it's just, it sounds like an after school special. That's just what it sounds like, awareness. We need to wake up, so to speak, you know, we're just kind of going through our lives and just listening to anything that that's on the radio, whether it be good for me or bad for me or whatever the case may be. I feel like he's more so bringing awareness that music can teach you something, you know? So I think if that's his goal, he knocked that out the park. But if this song was made to go on the radio to compete with the bullshit that's out there, this is not what that's doing to me. Yeah. I'm very excited to get into more from Proverb because
please give us suggestions. I think
he killed this though.
Please give us suggestions. That's the best way to end it. Make no mistake about it. We've been a little critical on certain things, but he absolutely bodied this from a just skill technical standpoint. We really appreciated it. But hey, man, shout out to Proverb, man. Yep, shout out to everybody that requested that. I'm happy that we did it. We happy that we got around to that. That's the end of the video, guys. If you enjoyed that, please hit the like button. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. I'm George. That's Ryan, Las Vegas.
We out.
We out.